हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विथ अ न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज़ स्क्रू गॉज. इट इज़ द पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर वन मेजरमेंट. सो इन अर्लियर वीडियो यू हैव रेड अबाउट दैट वर्नियर कैलिपर. सो द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज़ दैट स्क्रू गॉज. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, दिस पर्टिकुलर इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज़ यूज फॉर मेजरिंग द लेंथ. दिस इज कॉल्ड स्क्रू गॉज. ओके, सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वी आर हैविंग वन प्रिंसिपल. द प्रिंसिपल इज़ दैट एन ऑर्डिनरी स्क्रू हैज़ थ्रेड ऑन इट at equal distance along the length, means it is having different threads. Okay, threads are marked over here. Okay, I think it is visible or not visible, perhaps it is not visible clearly. Let it be focused. Okay, it will be visible. On rotating the head, when we rotate this particular head, so what is happening now? This particular head is going in forward direction or in the backward direction, means it is moving linearly along its axis, means it is having one axis, and in that it is moving, either it is moving forward or it is moving backward, like this. Clear? So what is happening over here? The linear distance which the screw move in one complete rotation, okay, means when we are rotating, if we are taking this from this particular zero and we are rotating, when it is completing one complete rotation, okay, means one complete rotation, that is equal to the distance between the consecutive threads, means it is the distance, means the distance between the points over here. Here you can see the small linings over here. Okay, these are in millimeter or mm we tell. Clear with this? These are in mm. So these are the consecutive threads over here. Okay, and one more term is used over here, that is called pitch. The distance, means what is pitch over here? The pitch of a screw is the distance moved along the axis by screw in one complete rotation of its head. When this head is rotating once, if suppose we are taking from the point zero, again when zero will come, we are rotating in one direction. So this complete is called one rotation, and this is the pitch of this. Clear with this? So in this we will see that how do we measure the length of any of the thing. We will find the least count of this, and in this particular the pitch, the length of the pitch we are having over here, okay, the pitch of the screw, which is 1 mm. okay, you can measure this and you can see over there, it is means of 1 mm over here. Clear with this? And this is called the pitch or the length of the pitch. So if we measure any of the thing, okay, so it is measuring in this particular length is measuring in the mm, and this particular is further the 100 division of the mm. okay, so we will see that how to find the least count first. After that we will see how to measure the length of any of the thing in this particular screw gauge. For finding the least count of this particular screw gauge, what we need to do over here, first of all we will see the pitch. So pitch of this particular screw gauge is 1 mm. okay, as I have shown over here, this particular length, this particular divisions, okay, these divisions are of 1 mm. okay, now it is visible clearly. So this particular distance are 1 mm. okay, and in this particular circular ring, okay, means what is happening over here, it is having 100 division. Okay, it is starting from 0, 10 20 30 40 70 80 90 90 to 100, up to here it is coming up to 100. So it is having 100 division. So when we are counting the least count, okay, the least count equals to the pitch. What is pitch? Pitch is equals to 1 mm. okay, that is divided by total number of divisions. So how many divisions we are having over here? These are the divisions. Okay, so we are having 100 divisions. So we are dividing this with 100. When we will divide, then we will get 0.01 mm, which is equals to 0.001 centimeter. So this particular is 0.001 centimeter, the least count of this particular screw gauge. Okay, so you have understood about the list count. So now we are coming that what are the terms over here. Okay, so this particular is called point A or stud. Okay, this is the first main point over here, or the first main part of this. Okay, and this is called point B, and this is called splinter. This moves to and fro, means it is moving forward direction also and backward direction also, and the screws are here over here. It is not visible from there. The screws we are having over here, means it is showing that how many turns we are taking towards or inward or outward, whatever, or forward direction or backward direction. So the one of the main thing is that we are having one main scale over here. Okay, one main scale, what I have shown earlier, that in mm form it was written, okay, that is called main scale. And below that particular main scale we are having one baseline, okay, means baseline is the line which we use for the finding the measurement, okay, that is the only line which give us the measurement. Here it is clearly visible that this particular line is called the baseline over here, okay, and this is the circular scale. And in this particular screw gauge what we are having circular scale of 100 division, and the length of this means in the main scale the length of main scale is 2.5 centimeter over here, okay, or 25 mm. So it is given over here. So the main function, we have to match these particular lines, means the circular scale with the baseline, and when we will in which point it is matching, that particular will be the length. So let's see how to find the length of any of the object by using screw gauge. So we are taking the cap of this particular pin to measure, we will measure its diameter, external diameter over here. So for that what we are doing, we are putting it in between of the point A and point B, means the stud and splinter, okay, this part is called, one part is the stud and one part is the splinter, or you can tell point A and point B. This particular is known as point A and this particular is known as point B. So here when it is completely fixed over here, okay, so it is completely fixed, not too much tight, okay, because it is not pure metallic. So if we will keep on means taking that forward, then it will move, okay, and this cap will squinch over here. So what we are doing, we are putting that so that it is means not suppressing that, okay, it is not compressing that particular cap. So we are taking the measurement of this. So we have fixed this particular cap, and now what we will do, we will see that we will count the number of lines over here, okay. So in order to count the number of line, so here we are counting the number of line, okay, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, okay, so 10 lines we are having over here, okay. And after that particular 10 line, we are having one more line which is not visible over here, okay. Once more counting, 1 2 3 4 5 6 5 6 7 8 9 and one more 10, okay. So 10th line is, 9th line is visible over here, and the 10th line it is not visible. So after that what we are doing, we are having one, this is the baseline over here, okay, we will see that which particular line is coinciding with the baseline, okay. So now we are seeing this is the 20th division, 20 21 22 23 23, okay, so 23 is the division over here, okay. So what we are doing, first of all we will write that how many mm's we are having. We were having 9 mm over here, okay, plus we are having how many divisions, the division was 23. So the division was 23 over here. So 23 division is multiplied with 0.001 centimeter, okay. So here also we can convert that this into centimeter, that will be equals to 0.9 centimeter, plus we will have that is equals to 0.023 centimeter. So when we are measuring this, then it will be we will have 923 centimeter, 0.93 923 centimeter. This is the measurement of the cap what we have done over here, okay. So I think that the list count and the all thing is clear to you all, and you also know about that how to measure the length of any of the thing using screw gauge. So one thing, one more topic is there, or one more thing is there, the basic point over here, way to decrease the list count of the screw gauge. So how we will decrease the list count? In order to decrease the list count, we need to decrease the pitch, means this particular is to be decreased, the measurement over here whatever it is given, so this particular need to be decreased over here, okay. We, when we will decrease this particular the pitch, then what will happen, the list count will decrease. Or the second thing is that we can increase the number of divisions over here. Here we are using 100 divisions, so further we can use 200 division, 300 division, 500 division, like that. Minimum 500 means after 100 we can use 500, 200, whatever division we like, okay. So for this particular we are having one more thing, that is called the zero error, okay. Means in that particular zero error, we are seeing that what is the error, whether it is means screw gauge is having any error or not. If it is not having any error, then error in the measurement, then it is called zero error, okay. So So for that zero error, what we need to do, we are having that the pitch over here and the baseline. You all know what is the baseline over here. Okay, now it is visible. The baseline is visible to you all. So from this particular baseline, what we will see when we are taking that to the initial position, then baseline should coincide with the zero, means zero marker is over here and it should coincide with the zero baseline. So if it is coinciding with the zero, baseline is coinciding with the zero, then we tell that it is having zero error. So now you can see that it is coinciding with the zero, the baseline is coinciding with zero. So it is little shiny. So wait one second. Now you see the baseline is coinciding with zero. Okay, so this particular is the baseline, here is the baseline over here, okay, and it is coinciding with zero. So it is called zero error screw gauge. So when we measure any of the length, okay, so what is happening, we are having zero, we no need to subtract, no need to add any of the thing over here. So this is called zero error. One more thing is that in zero error we are having two kinds. One is positive zero error and the second is negative zero error. In positive zero error, what is happening, the baseline is going downward, okay, means the baseline is having, means it is not coming to the zero, baseline is like this, means it is coming to the 5, 10 or whatever, means the zero is below the baseline. So it is called positive zero error. And when zero will go above the that is baseline, means baseline will be below and zero will go above, means 90 or 95, 97, it will come in the baseline point. So it is called negative zero error. So how to means calculate this particular positive and negative zero error? In that we will count that in, if we are having the positive zero error, means it is like this, okay, it is means 5 is colliding with the baseline, so we are having the zero error of 5. So fifth division, we will find the measure of the fifth division. So in order to find the measure of the fifth division, okay, let's consider that this particular vernier, this particular screw gauge is having positive zero error and the division is fifth division. So how we will calculate the positive zero error? So if it is in the fifth division, so what we have to do in order to calculate this, we will multiply this particular division. Fifth division is multiplied with the least count. Least count we already found over here. This particular is the least count. So we are having this particular is equals to 0.005 centimeter. So we have calculated that the positive zero error, whatever we are having over here, so it is 5 into 10, 0.001 centimeter we multiplied. So this particular is the error over here. So what we will do for correct zero error, what we will do, correct reading, we are having that observed reading minus zero error, whatever is the observed reading. If suppose we are measuring on any of the thing, if suppose we have measured this particular, so if the observed reading, whatever the observed reading we were having, observed reading OR, I am writing observed reading, okay, OR is we are having 0.923 centimeter, and zero error that will be equals to what, we are having 0.005 centimeter. So what we will do, observed reading minus zero error. So here correct reading, correct reading that will be equals to 0.923 minus 0.005 centimeter, okay. So this particular will be the correct reading over here. So when we will subtract this, then we will get over here 0.918 centimeter. So this particular will be the correct reading over here. So similarly for the negative zero error, it will, what will happen, means the zero will move up upside of the baseline. So if suppose it is coming to the 95, okay, so it is coming to the 95th division. So what we will do over here, first of all, for the negative zero error, what we need to do, we need to subtract that will be equal to minus sign is added over here, 100 minus 95, that is multiplied with the least count. Least count we are having 0.001 centimeter. So we are having 0.005 centimeter in with a negative sign. So here when we are calculating the correct value, okay, correct reading for this, then we are taking the same for that. So 0.923, that is with a minus, okay, and again this is अगेन इन द माइनस साइन, माइनस ऑफ 0.005 सेंटीमीटर. ओके, सो व्हाट वी आर हैविंग, वी विल वी मीन्स दिस पर्टिकुलर माइनस माइनस विल बी कैंसल्ड एंड इट विल बी एडेड ओवर हियर. सो व्हेन वी विल ऐड दिस देन वी विल हैव द मेजर 8 सेंटीमीटर. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर विल बी द मेजर व्हेन वी आर हैविंग नेगेटिव. सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई थिंक दैट यू ऑल हैव गॉट दैट हाउ टू फाइंड द जीरो एरर एंड ऑल. वंस यू गो थ्रू दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सरसाइज एंड वट एवर फ्रॉम वेयर आई हैव स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द स्क्रू गॉज, यू गो थ्रू दैट एंड डिस्क्रिप्शन एंड दैट ऑल. After that, whatever doubt you will have, you can ask it during your classes. And when we will have the practical, that time you can find the zero error and that all, positive, negative, zero error, whatever the errors you are having, and solve the numericals of this particular chapter. Thank you.